We are beginning tonight on the Crime Watch and a major bust for Santa Cruz police.
That's right. Local investigators say they worked with federal agents to arrest a major player in one of the world's most notorious gangs. Jose Abrego is suspected of being a high-ranking member of the street gang MS-13. He's facing charges of re-entering the U.S. illegally after being deported multiple times. Action News reporter Stephanie Trong has details live from Santa Cruz tonight.
Dan, while the gang's numbers aren't big here in Santa Cruz, police say those gang members are a top priority because of how violent they've been. A warning now, our opening video may be disturbing to some of our viewers. This is video of the initiation into the internationally notorious Latin American street gang MS-13. 13 punches and kicks before this guy's officially part of the crew, one known for brutal attacks and murders using their signature weapon of choice, the machete.
It's something we've actually taken off of gang members here.
Santa Cruz police spokesman Zach Friend says there's a growing population of MS-13 gang members living in the city. That's why federal agents and Santa Cruz investigators have begun to target them, arresting this suspected shot caller, 30-year-old Jose Abrego, who's been deported 3 times in the past 8 years and arrested by Santa Cruz police 3 times since he came back to the U.S. sometime after 2005.
We have drug and alcohol-related arrests, including some DUIs.
Abrego's arrest is part of a new effort between Immigration and Customs Enforcement, or ICE, and Santa Cruz police. Under Operation Community Shield, a nationwide effort that began in 2005, ICE has been partnering up with local police departments, sharing intel on gang members who are here in the U.S. illegally.
ICE certainly could provide resources to us that we just otherwise wouldn't have available to us.
All in an effort to take down a gang with dozens of members in Santa Cruz County. While it's weak in numbers, its power lies in the severity of its violent crimes.
There are dealing with significant drug trades within our city, heroin, methamphetamines, and marijuana. In the last few years, their homicides are brutal acts of violence.
One of those murders happened here at the levee last Thanksgiving holiday. This is where Santa Cruz police say a man was shot 12 times in point-blank range. These flowers, the only reminder left of that vicious MS-13 execution-style killing.
We're initiating a full-court press against gangs here in Santa Cruz. We've got the DEA, ICE. We've got the FBI working with us to really stop this flow.
Santa Cruz is probably not the place to come commit a crime. We've put forth all the resources that we possibly can to combat the gang problem in the city.
Santa Cruz police say there's no end date with its partnership with ICE, and officers say they're confident that Abrego's arrest is just the start of taking down many local big-time gang members. Dan?
All right. Thank you very much, Stephanie. Abrego is set to be in federal court tomorrow facing immigration charges. If convicted, he could do 2 years in prison and pay a $250,000 fine before being deported for the 4th time back to El Salvador.